champagne. He's counting money. He's not sick. Can't believe he betrayed us. Money isn't everything, guys.
Thank you for Suyin and Sayan Lee for the speech. I think I remember I always go to WeBuildSG to listen to the podcast. I think the one you didn't mention.
Yes, yeah. We have a podcast, but since I moved my house, we have stopped it for a while. We will start it, and many of you in the audience shall be a podcast guest target, so keep a lookout.
Then again, thank you for you guys for coming today. And as today's, luckily I just the date, so one day before, one day after the release. And we give a presentation about showing that what is the main, the new features in the low 1.6, and what's the difference between 1.6 and 1.5.
It's okay, but if you hear it yesterday, the thing won't be released.
How much, I guess?
Actually, the big difference is 1.3 and 1.4.
Yeah, I think the big difference is 1.4 and 1.5. Because 1.5, the linker, everything is new in the go. It's bit of a C.
1.5 is DC.
More manageable. Everything is more. It's improvement in the both like the garbage collector and also like the runtime. There's a lot of change. Let me quick through about the history of Go. So it was released on 2012. So
that long ago?
Exactly like 6 years ago. I mean, so there's a 0. Something like 6 years ago.
Yes.
1.0 is 2012, which is 2 years ago.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. So if you go to the blog, golang.org, there's a post, 6 year blog. It was originally developed by Google.
Yep.
So after that, like every, I think recently, every 6 months, it changed, it updated the new versions. On, 1.5 is in August last year, and the 1.6, is submitted today. Yeah. February is 18th, 2016. So if you want to, you can download Golang 1.6 by this address. The new update is the full slides will be on the talks. Golang SGs, but like, today I will only like show what is the main, some new features I'm excited about. So to talk about the standard libraries, there's a three main changes in the three libraries: NetHTTP, the text template, and the short table, a short package for the net. HTTP. Just I want to quick show hand here. Who know about? Have you ever used HTTP 2 before?
Wow, you're the soul hero.
Kind.
So HTTP 2 is actually a new, kind of a new standard that you remember that your browser using that. You know that was the current protocol. Was our version 1.1?
Yeah.
Yes. So the drawback of 1.0, 1.1 is, I remember that once you start a server and you have a client and listen to the server, and you don't want to listen to the server anymore. You cannot kill the server. The server cannot kill the client. Because the connection is actually sent in one way, and there's too many communication. Shake hands, back and forth, back and forth. So CP2 is a new standard on, I think, yes, let me show you a demo. So here's how it's again an example how to implement HP2 in Go 1.5. We have to use I think in Go 1.5 is actually the HP2 is an experimental package from Google. So you have to import golang.org.x.net.hp2, and you have to define like the server should be point to address H0H0, and subset will handle functions. And in Go 1.6, okay, let me show you when you run this one, then what do you see in the command. Why is that working?
Because it doesn't support HTTP.
Yeah.
Your Chrome?
Because I use Chrome. It's the original Chrome. So for HTTP2 to be working, you have to run on like newest browser, for example
50.
Canary.
Yeah, Canary. So
Chrome is not new enough.
Which browser to support HTTP2? Firefox?
The trouble is the HTTP2.org.org. Let's make sure the browser supports HTTP2.
Anyway, I don't know. Yeah, but you can see from the terminal, it actually cancels it.
Can you like curl it maybe?
Oh, this one actually bring out the header. For HTTP2, it sends actually the binary.
Yeah, I was wondering what curl support was. Never mind.
So if you want to look at the code, then it's here.
Yeah, this is the 1.5.
Yeah, so in 1.5, you have to like explicitly define HTTP2 server request point to the source address, and you have to import it from the Google and the Golang experimental package. In Go 1.6, you can do it, faster. So actually, you HTTP2, we will integrate directly inside the net.http. So once you are using HTTPS by default, you are actually on HTTP2. So this one, actually, you just remove the all those stuff related to HTTP2, then actually you are on HTTP2 already.
What happens if your browser doesn't support HTTP2 and you have a Golang net HTTP?
I think it falls back to 1.1, I think.
Okay.
It depends. I think it depends on how the browser and response will handle the request. Just now you see it's actually convert to the download request instead of displaying full text. Okay, back to the presentation. Yeah, so it's how, I mean, so if you want to run a normal HTTP 1.1 in your Golang 1.6, you have to set some configurations. You have to, I think you have to set the parameters in the transportation layer. You can read more in the Golang release. So, okay, the second change is in the introduction of block action. Text and HTML template package, you usually, I mean, how you render the HTML code, I mean, for any your static code, actually can use this template.
It's a good idea. Sort JSON.
Okay, so you can see from here the here's one example. Golang learn from some language and they actually they add a trick. So actually when you use a curly brackets and you add a dash, then actually you automatically clear the space. So for them, is this code? I want to print something here, and I add a range and means is a for loop, and we actually clear all the space in between. So for them, I want to this list. I have a list of all the names, and I want to call the print function. So the template dot function mapped. We actually join all this string and print out nicely on the template. So if you run this code, yeah. So here's the code. And I tried to run this one. Okay, so you can, or can you see it from the behind?
That's only runs.
Yes, so technically the block actions, the new block actions, we help you to, instead of template, you can redefine the template many times. So this one is a new things. Yeah, I myself I should try to use more, because I will replace the template and use it in different places. For example, you have a layout file, and you have a header, and then you have a footer, and that page actually used by many pages. So by using block, you can define the default value for the header, just like for example, Golang sheet, and the body will be the meetup, speech or something. So yeah, I think it's like quite useful for if I develop, I want to generate HTML using Golang. Okay, anyone use C in Go here? Or anyone?
C libraries.
C libraries.
1.4 broke my C library. 1.5 made it work again, and 1.6 I'm still testing.
Yeah, I think one thing I love about Go is that I'm able to import. I'm not sure, is it able to import Python to Go?
Yeah.
No. Maybe in the future. But I see that because Go actually originally built in C.
Yes.
So for Go 1.4, from 1.4 to 1.5, they use Google used Go 1.4 to compile the binary for lower 0.5. For and go for 1.6, you use low 1.5 to compile for the low 1.6.
Yeah.
But actually, then from the low 1.4, you can compile for all the libraries from 1.4 or 1.5 and above. So yeah, that's one thing. I think I'm very good at C though, but I mean this one might be useful if you use like IoT device, which actually is cool. I think read you use some IoT device and you will probably you use some C library. Then we can
yes, I mean yes.
Yeah, so like you can call it. I mean you will use low code and running the server.
Actually, for me, the biggest pain point I had with C/Go is 1.3 worked very well. 1.4, because they changed the garbage collector, it illegally collected some of the C pointers and it crashed the program. 1.5 fixed the problem, and hoping 1.6 remains fixed. So it's quite scary.
Yeah,
if you use PEMI's ZeroMQ library, which I use a lot.
So when you go build with the C library, it builds in the, it drags in the
yeah, it's basically, that C library is basically a C library. And it tries to read all the C library pointers, garbage collect those pointers which are not supposed to be garbage collected, and it crashes the system. So the good thing about Go is garbage collected. The bad thing about Go 1.4 is the garbage collector's bug. But 1.5, so far touch wood, fixed the problem.
1.6?
I'm still testing before I release the production.
Oh yeah, because my slide actually not running on Google App Engine. So it's not able to compile. Okay, the next one, runtime. So now I think Golang one bicycle be a bit smarter. So I mean if you use Go race to like detect the race conditions in your Golang, then now Go one basic actually you can tell you like if you run this code, yeah, you have like a random access to a map, which actually you should like add maybe a mutex, or you should use a channel. Yeah, use a channel to make it like synchronized.
Yes.
Because
use channels.
Yeah. And because basically for speed, if you use map. Like, map is unsafe for concurrent access. So, yeah.
Actually, I didn't know that map was unsafe for concurrent access until 6.
Okay. So now Go 1.6, we support more operating systems. So Windows. Usually, last time I run a library on Windows, I need to specify the OS environment. And I think more devices are coming, especially iOS and Android. So that's why you see Go 1.6 can run. I think for 1.5, and now 1.6 can run on, can compile to iOS or like Android app. So yeah, you can see the future. Yes, it's not iOS. Oh, and yeah, that's a new thing is vendor support. So maybe you have a quick show handy, like when we use any like dependency management tool in your GoLang.
Okay.
For example, like GoDev.
GoDev.
Or Light.
The ones you get with it.
Yeah, so for Go 1.6, it's actually an upgrade from 1.5. So 1.5 is like its primary feature. But in 1.6, you have it by default. Like if you put everything in vendor, then it will your local code will look up for the library the package inside the vendor first. I mean the so for example, I have on server one and server two, in the main in the two files vendor go, I import a Gorilla Mux MUX library. And also in the server two, I have a /gorilla/mux file. So the server one we use the library from GitHub, like from the Go part. But for the second one, it use the one from the vendor. So probably I don't know, probably shouldn't use Go then. But anyway, I think it's a lot. There may be some change. You know that they also want to maintain the freedom for a lot of users, so maybe there are some discussion going on. Yes, and last question. Oh, sorry. Okay, garbage collector. This is a every time, I mean, when I see the new versions, I will see the garbage collectors come first. Like, here's a, what happened is 1.4 jump to 1.5. So, I don't think it's a lot much because, I mean, it's just like compare between the garbage collector poses on the heap size, but in the 1.6, I think the change, the improvement is quite notable. So you can see that on the heap size it's actually increased like a few gigabytes.
Wow, 250 gigabytes. Oh, yeah. Who is the heap that big?
Yeah, so I think I believe one of the things like, for example, there's a lot of improvement in the small package library. Mm-hmm. For example, you use Sharp, right? Let's see. It has some improvements on to.
When you look at the time, it's all less than 40 milliseconds. Yeah, so.
Apart from that, I think there's a lot of a change, I mean, for the tooling, for the runtime, I mean, how in the Golang 1.6 compatible with that? Actually, you can run and compile on different platform. And yeah, if you, I mean, my presentation doesn't cover, you know, everything. So I mean, if you find something interesting, you can come up with make a switch next time. Yeah, any question?
You have the generics every year.
Thank you for asking.
You work together,
generics are all generics.
Everybody wants generics.
It's very clear that they're not coming to the world language.
Yeah, thank you. If you're a beginner, right? Are you a beginner?
Beginner? No. Well, I write in the hobby. So.
Okay, cool. So, what happened? We can start with the small projects. And your last time, I started with like a chatbot. So it's like very simple. It's just a response, receive, send a request, and update the response. So it can be like an app.
Request for generics?
No. This question is, will generics ever come to go? I don't think so. Not yet. Not in the near future. Don't hold your breath.
Because, for example,
Saw.
Yeah. See, it's just like metaprogramming on strings.
Yeah. Go is too strongly tied with all these things. Although Scala can be good, actually.
Yeah, some of I think it depends on what the purpose you are going to achieve. Like, for, what's the purpose you want to do for me?
Sorting was a problem, for example. I have to implement it for each type.
Yes.
or going some complicated structures or classes, data types?
I think from what I know, it in Go, I think it has very less support for like verify the list or like short list or like. So those things, if you would do something, you have to use some library.
Maybe I have to forget some Java. Yes.
So I mean, that's always like most important when you are using language. There's a lot of things. I mean, right now even those things,
actually,
very funny. They have to new programs.
I don't really miss generics that much, really. And I found that one of the things that Go helps with my code is as the project grows older, when you go into maintenance phase, it's actually easier to maintain because it is stupid easy. Go is stupid easy. While you try to do the same thing in Scala, you're scratching your head trying to figure out what did I try to do 2 years ago. I can't even figure out what I tried to do. But Go, it's standing at you, it's easy.
But at least in Go, sometimes you have lots of action, like if type is int one way, if type is string second way.
It is.
You do not need it in case of.
It is very repetitive and it's very stupid code.
Yes.
But it's obvious. So as far as maintenance is concerned, it's easy. Yes.
Lots of repetition is easy, but.
No.
Just one thing, right?
Yeah. You have a point there, but on the whole, generics in that case is...
Okay, so there's a blog post from... I think the link I post in the first slide, the deep dot, we introduce a list of all the changes in the Go 1.6. So I mean, if you are interested, and you can maybe go to the blog.golang.org. Yeah, it has all the lists. Any more questions?
Thank you for the great update, Ed.
Thank you. Because I believe that Golang compared to like in Java or like Pycoms, we are like, growing communities. So I believe there is someone
can
else come
here. Can I make a shout out?
Yes.
Has anyone made an API with Golang? I'm just interested to hear how you might have done authentication or something. Just please talk to me. I'm going to go get a beer.
The second beer.
Okay,
so again, right now there's some conference going on. Buffer, India. I think this is like tomorrow is Sunday. So
tomorrow.
Yes, there's some other conference during this year. I think one in Europe and one in Denver. US, and we even have a chance to attend. This will be like a great time to meet. Right now, I think both of them are still attending Bookman India, so I'm waiting for their updates.
Bengaluru,
is it?
Bangalore. Okay.
So,
do they wear turbans in Bangalore?
Sounds good.
Yeah, thank you for coming to the talk today, and we hope you like the food. And, thank you. We have a few speakers here if you would have one.